You're way overdue.
Yes, yes, yes.
Way overdue.
Yes, yes.
You know what he got this morning? Yeah. He got his star on the Walk of Fame. Yeah. Now, my first question to you is, what took him so long?
That's what I've been wondering. I started to go over there and look at him. And you know, when I look at him, they don't know what to say. I started going and asking, what is it? What's wrong?
Yes.
I started to tell him. But you know, I think it was a bunch of old people that didn't know what was going on, never had it, can't get it, don't want to know where to find it. And what they did, they just didn't put my vote in. But I got it now, and they can't take it back.
Yes.
I think they was waiting for me to die. You know, they like to give them to you after you die. Well, he was here. Been here and gone, and but he was good. But I'm still here, and I got it, and I had a chance to touch it.
Because you know what?
And what makes it so good, I cried. I had to cry because I was so full. I've been waiting 46 years. And I knew somebody should have voted on me in that length of time. I said, what did I do? Where did I go? What did I say? Uh-huh. And so finally, they put me down in the ground. Not in the box.
You know what? They are lucky they did, because they don't want you to come read them.
No, they don't.
Oh.
They don't. No, Richard, they don't. Woo. No, they don't, because I know how to do it.
Mm-hmm.
I give them two snaps and a broken wrist.
Yes. If little Richard reads you, the library is open.
Did you hear that? Did you? And that is the truth. I've been waiting to get back on here.
Well, I'm glad. But
I've been waiting.
One more honor we got to talk about.
Oh, yes.
Our mayor has decided that this will be Little Richard Day.
That's right.
Little Richard Day.
That's right. That's right.
And you know,
I watched you the other night. I watch you every night.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard you say that if he gave Little Richard one day, it's gonna be every day.
But is one day enough?
No. Not when you've been waiting 46 years. One day ain't nothing. Bradley, I love you, baby. We're the same age, so I can say this.
Yeah.
I love you, and I appreciate that one day, but it's gonna be tomorrow, too. I really appreciate it. You know, when you've been singing 46 years, and you're the architect of rock and roll, and they don't even wanna give you credit for that. When I started singing rock and roll, wasn't nobody singing it. Listen, when I started, woo, wasn't nobody saying that.
Richard.
Nobody saying?
Wait, we about to have church.
You that's right.
Yes, 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 yes.
See, when I started, woo, they weren't saying that. They were saying, woo, woo, woo. Mm-hmm. You understand me? And when I was wop, bobble, loo, bobble, lop, wasn't nobody doing that.
So what you're saying, basically in a nutshell, you're saying that you haven't gotten the credit you deserve.
I have never gotten it. They always wanted to give it. See, I'm black, and I am not
wait,
a racist.
Wait, I didn't know you was black. Oh. Oh, let's take a commercial. I didn't know you. No, I'm just kidding.
Being a black singer out of Georgia, which I love my hometown, Macon, Georgia, is one of the greatest places in the world.
And Detroit.
And Detroit. But being a black singer out of Macon, Georgia, see what happened to me? See, they didn't want a black guy to be the one to create rock and roll, because the white kids liked it. And they didn't want the white girl screaming over no black boy. And by me being a black guy and a good-looking black guy. And you know I'm not conceited.
No, no.
I've never been that way.
No.
You know I don't believe in stuff like that.
I hope don't nobody mistake this.
I hope don't. I'm not conceited.
I'm convinced.
let me ask you about the music that's coming off the radios today, rap music, Two Live Crew, controversy, obscenity. Tell me, talk about the music.
I think that those old folk that they got in charge, they need to be fired. See, the thing that has happened, they done got too old to do anything, can't do it, don't know how to do it, never did, and mad with the ones that are doing it. See, what is wrong is, and I want to tell you something, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen of all races, that don't take this thing lightly. And you said, don't take it for granted, because your freedom of being in jeopardy, they're trying to stop your freedom. Yeah. See, this country was built on freedom of speech. Yeah. 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 Wait a minute, wait. Shut up.
Forgot about it.
You have a right to sing what you want to sing, whether it's good or bad. You have a right to wear what you want to wear, whether it's pretty or ugly. You have a right to go where you want to go, regardless. You understand me? If you want to buy a pornography, a tape, or whatever it is, you have a right to do it. You understand me? And if those young guys were Two Live Crew,
yeah,
if they want to sing whatever they sing, I may not like it, but I ain't got to buy it. To look at it. I may not buy it, I may not listen to it, but they have a right to sing it. You understand me? You have a right to be, you got a right to worship God, you got the right to be Jewish, Catholic, a Seventh-day Adventist, a Baptist, Methodist, Pentecostal. That's your right. Can't nobody tell you what type of church you should go. That's your right. Yeah. And God gave you that. Listen, I want to let you know that God gave it to you, and it's in the word of God, your freedom of being taken. Stand up for it.
Whoa. Whoa, happy day.
You sound like you want to preach, little Richard.
No, not with the ponytail. Oh.
That you actually did the wedding of Demi and Bruce?
Yeah, I performed Bruce's wedding. I performed the wedding for, what is his name? John Brinker. Uh-huh. And Bruce Springsteen. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna perform yours if you want me to.
Yes, yes. I
know that'll be 20 years from now, but I still wanna do it.
If you preach like you did tonight, I want you doing my wedding.
I get down more than that.
Really?
Oh, I let the loose. I do it.
You know, you're very outspoken. Is there anything that you're afraid of?
Yes, I am. Crazy people.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. All of you, the pretty one and the ugly one, shut up. Let me tell you something. Crazy people are gonna ruin this country. See, the people that, these religious fanatics, they're gonna call people that are true Christians religious fanatics. But there are some people that are just devils and call themselves Christians. You understand me? And they want you to stop doing everything. They tell you that they don't look at no book, and up on their mattress ain't nothing but books. They tell you that they don't drink, and up under their, bottles everywhere. You understand me? And you got to remember that you got to protect yourself by studying for yourself. You don't take what no preacher tell you. Read for yourself.
I'm not sure whether that was the answer I was looking for, but...
Amen. That's not it. Ask the question again.
No, you afraid of crazy people?
I'm afraid. Kind. And people look at me. I had a guy look at me. He told me I didn't look right.
Oh.
I couldn't understand that.
He was old.
Yeah, and he was ugly.
You're gonna do another song for
us? Oh, yes, I am.
What are you gonna do? Yeah. Yeah. Wait, let's find out. Wait now.
Let's find out what it is. It might be a Milli Vanilli song. Find out what he gonna do.
I do favor one of them.
Shut up!
I want to say hello to a little friend of mine. His name is Keith. He's sick. Uh-huh. Keith, I love you. And to my sister Peggy, uh-huh. Sylvia, and to Ernestine, uh-huh. and to Elaine, to Margaret, yeah. to Hattie.
We'll
and
be
to
right
James
back.
Barry.
He's going to do a song. Some song. He's going to do my song.
Song dedicated to his late mom and one dedicated to you all. This is Little Richard.
Dedicated to my mother. Traveling all over this country, sleeping in a different bed every night. Sing the world in all its glory. What a beautiful sight. But my mind keep going back to days long ago. I can still see my sweet mama. She cooking on that old wooden stove. When the preacher would come for dinner, she would say, "Now, kids, y'all better act right. Won't you mind your manners, clean your plates, and little Richard, would you try to keep quiet?" Every night before she'd go to bed, she would blow out the coal all night. And I hear say, "Lord, keep him safe all through the night." Because there's no place like home. All over this country I have gone. No place like home. When my daddy and my mama gone, I feel so all alone. I can say there's no place like home. Ooh, no place like home. Dedicated to my mother and to all my friends everywhere. We're still with God, you know.
Love me. what you done to me.
Ready for something new?
You know me.
This is Little Richard. Peace. Go, Richard.
Hotel accommodations arranged by Best Western. For reservations at any of the 1900 Best Western hotels, motor inns, and resorts in the USA and Canada, call toll-free. Best Western, the world's largest lodging chain.